Now we are discussing the coaxial cable. Well, we already know that in the transmission medium, there are two types. One is the guided and another is the unguided. Guided means wired. So in the wired medium, we are having the coaxial cable. Now, talking about the coaxial cable, the best example is the TV wire. There is a wire which is coming at our TV. Just like I am assuming that it is a Tata Sky or maybe talking about your dish TV. So from your dish antenna to your Tata Sky, one wire is coming. That wire is called the coaxial cable. From your Tata Sky to TV, that is the HDMI cable that we are now talking about. From your Tata Sky or dish TV to the dish which is placed at your home on the top of the roof, that is the wire we are talking about. That is called the coaxial cable, and that carry many channels together. They are using this type of wire for the TV. There is a specific purpose because many of the frequency, different channels, it can come through that. So now we are discussing the coaxial cable. So this one is the coaxial cable. Now the first thing about the coaxial cable is that it transmits the data at very high speed. So transmit at high data rate, the meaning is that at very high speed we are going to transmit the data. Let us suppose we are having a LED TV at our home. We are also having one setup box, let us suppose some Tata Sky or Airtel TV. At the roof of your home, we are having one dish antenna from which the cable channels comes. The wire which is connecting the LED TV to the Tata Sky, that wire is usually the HDMI cable. And the wire which is connecting the Tata Sky or some cable operator to the dish antenna, that is the wire we are talking about. This is the coaxial cable. So this wire is very much important because that is going to provide you very high speed. Now, talking about the coaxial cable, we are having one diagram over there. So if I talk about the coaxial cable, it is having the group of specially wrapped and insulated wires. Specially wrapped means the wire is having so much insulation that there will be no noise coming from outside. That's why the TV which we are having, just like ultra definition TV or high definition TV, there you can see that very good quality comes. And good quality come from these wires only. So this is the coaxial cable. Now talking about this cable, there is a central copper wire surrounded by PVC insulation. So this one is the wire which is the middle wire. This is called the central copper wire. And you know that whenever we are using the connector of the Tata Sky or the dish TV, then inside that there is a wire which is going inside that Tata Sky. And this wire is the central copper wire. Now this wire is having the outer insulation, and this is of PVC, polyvinyl chloride. So you can see that the central copper wire is having the insulator. Insulator means so that this wire is not matched with the above wire, because we know that there are two wires which always moves. One is positive and one is negative. So inner wire is having the covering so that it should not take the frequency of the above wire. And the central wire is called the inner conductor through which the data is passing. This PVC insulation is further covered with metal shield of copper mesh. So now above this PVC, you can see here, this one is the outer conductor. There are two conductors. One is the inner conductor called central copper wire, and one is the outer conductor. This is a shield. It is also called the metal shield. So this metal shield is also connected to the connector, and by the inner conductor and the outer conductor, they are using as the positive and negative, and they are giving us the signal from the dish. Now this metal sleeve is shielded by the thick PVC insulator. So again, after this metal shield, we are having the insulation. So this one is the one more insulation of PVC. So you can see that this is further having the plastic cover. So this one is the plastic cover. Now, if I talk about the coaxial cable, one is the inner conductor having the PVC covering, then the metal shield, then again PVC covering, then again plastic cover. So this wire is so much secure that outside interference or noise will not come in and just mixing with your signal. That's why we can broadcast very high definition signals or the channels from that. And this is the reason, because of that, this coaxial cable is used for the televisions. Now, talking about coaxial cable, there are two other names. One is the cheaper net and second one is the thin net. So cheaper net, it is another name of coaxial cable. Why? The reason is that the coaxial cable is very easy to install and it is very cheap in price. That's why it is called the cheaper net. So if you are going to install the Tata Sky or Dish TV or any cable connection at your home, it will not cost you so much. It is very nominal cost by which you can install the TV connection at your home. That's why it is called the cheaper net. And second thing, it is called the thin net. Well, there are two types of cables in that. One is the thin net and second one is the thick net. So you can see here, one we are having is thin net, which is called the thin Ethernet. Now it is having the 50 ohm. Actually, the impedance is taken into the ohms and the category means type of cable is RG58. Similarly, we are having thick Ethernet. Thick means which is having some high width. Again, it is having the 50 ohm RG11. Then we are having the cable TV. For the cable TV, whatever we are using is 75 ohm, that is RG59. So these are some of the category of the cable, right, which are used for different purposes: RG59, RG58, RG11. So one for the cable TV, one for the thin net. Thin means just is having the small diameter. Then we are having thick. Thick means the large diameter. So coaxial cable is most popular with the name of thin net because of its diameter is 0.35 centimeter. Because of this small diameter, it is very easy to install and you can move it anywhere. Into the pipes, you can put it anywhere underground piping. So these are the two popular names of the coaxial cable. Now we are talking about the advantages and disadvantages of coaxial cable. The first and the foremost advantage of the coaxial cable is that it provides the high bandwidth. More the bandwidth, more data can carry. So if we are having more bandwidth, it will be having the high amount of data which can be passed through the coaxial cable. Then we are having second thing is the high data rate. So high rate of 10 Mbps. That means you can see that it is having very fast transmission. Through this coaxial cable, we can send the fast signals. Then one good thing about the coaxial cable is that it can cover long distance. Means from your cable TV to at your home, if the wire is coming, it can cover the long distance. There is no as such problem. And it is also having the high noise immunity. High noise immunity stands for if the outer area is having some noise, just like we have learned so many noises, okay, thermal noise, induced noise. So such type of noise cannot affect the coaxial cable. If the effect is there, it will be very less. So it is very high noise immunity. So it is immune to that. And it is also less expensive than the fiber optic cable. If I compare with the twisted pair cable, obviously it is having more expensive, but as compared to optical fiber cable, it is the less expensive. So now we are talking about the disadvantages of coaxial cable. Although we are having many advantages of coaxial cable, but still, you know that connector is required for connecting the coaxial cable. If the poor shield connection is there, then it will result to the electric noise. If the wire is coming from your dish at your home and there you are having the Tata Sky, then you are going to put a connector. Now that connector is not properly tight. In that case, the electric noise will come and yes, it will just remove everything. Means the noise will come, the speed will be less, bandwidth will be less, obviously. So this is a disadvantage, means the proper connector should be used in that. And one more thing, despite of the small diameter, this thin net cannot be used for the Ethernet network. So even the coaxial cable is having the small diameter. Means there is a category thin net in the coaxial cable which is having the small diameter. But that cannot replace the Ethernet network. Means in the Ethernet network, we cannot use this cable. So these are the disadvantages of coaxial cable. Now, there are two types, or we can say that two kinds of coaxial cable. One is the baseband and second one is the broadband. So there are two categories of the coaxial cable, baseband and broadband. Baseband means something which is less. Broad means which is high. So as the name it is signifying, baseband we are talking about. In the baseband, it transmits a signal, single signal at a time. If we talk about one specific time, then only one signal can be passed. So this is called the baseband. Now it is used for the digital transmission. So it is going to pass on the 0 and 1s, that is the digital data, means the binary data can be passed, and it should be amplified at every 1000 feet. So after every 1000 feet, we need an amplifier so that this can be amplified. Now, one more thing, that it is used for the LAN, for the local area network. Now we are discussing the next type of coaxial cable, that is the broadband coaxial cable. So as the name signify, broadband means the band is very broad. So we can transmit many signals of different frequency at a single time. So at a specific time, we can transmit the many signals out of this broadband coaxial cable. And just like the baseband cable used for the digital communication, the broadband is used for the analog transmission. So the difference between baseband and broadband is very much clear. Baseband means one signal at a time. Broadband means multiple signal at a time. Baseband is having a digital transmission. Broadband is having the analog transmission. So by that difference, it is very much clear that for our cable TV, we use the broadband. Because in the cable TV, we are having many channels like colors. We are having ZTV or maybe any channels, news channels. So multiple channels coming through a single wire. And that is the example of broadband coaxial cable. So example is the cable TV. So now we are discussing what are the connectors which are used in the coaxial cable. So if we talk about the connector used in the coaxial cable, then the connector used is BNC. And BNC stands for Bionet Neil Conilman. So this is the connector that is used in the coaxial cable. Let us suppose that this is the cable which is coming. Now, this is the BNC connector. So this connector is used for connecting. So if we are having multiple cables and for that we need a connector, then this is the BNCT connector by which we can combine the different cables. Let us suppose one cable is coming here, one is here, and one at this side. So we can combine the different cables also. So this is again the 50 watt BNC terminator. And this one is the ground wire. So these are the connectors which are used in the coaxial cable. And many of time at your home, if you have seen in the streets, one wire is coming and out of that multiple coaxial cables are going, then these type of connectors are used, BNC connector. Although the coaxial cable coming before your Tata Sky, again that is the connector is the BNC connector. So this is the all about coaxial cable.